So, the big announcement. Tomorrow, on Monday, the 2nd of October, 2017, I'm... Welcome back to the Weekend Venture. So today is a really exciting day, and I'm so excited to share this special news with you. But first, I'm gonna head over to Orms, which is the camera shop in Cape Town, because I need to go pick up and test out a stabilizer. Hopefully it works with my camera, but that is the reason that we're going there for this upcoming event. It is such a beautiful day today. I think I'm gonna go mission later. So the only problem that I might have with the stabilizer is that my lens is very heavy, so ultimately my whole camera is pretty heavy. So that's why I'm just taking my other lens as well, which is the 18-135 kit lens, and we will see. Hopefully that isn't too heavy. But looking at the weights, my camera should be supported, but we will go find out.
Thank you very much. Enjoy your trip.
Thank you so much.
Yo, when you're flying out.
Thanks so much for your help. Really appreciate this.
I got the goods. 100% going on a mission later now. Got to test this thing out and not look like an amateur. I'm so excited now. Let's go home and play with this thing and get all the awesome shots. So quick update, I have made a pit stop next to the road with this amazing view looking over Cape Town. Just check that, and I'm going to make the announcement right here because why not? I wanted to do it outside, but I realized we're like right next to the highway. Right there, that is the highway. So needless to say, it is very annoyingly loud outside. So I'm gonna make the announcement right here inside my car, sitting in the passenger seat, because why not? Because what is life at the moment? I don't even know. Life is so exciting, life is so good, and it's just amazing. So, the big announcement. Tomorrow, on Monday, the 2nd of October, 2017, I am flying to Greece to work for Red Bull and shoot at their parkour event in Santorini. What is happening? What is life? How is this happening? I'm so excited. I didn't even know what to do with myself. It still feels so unreal. Like, how is this happening? How is this a thing? Like, a few months ago, I just got an email from Kamari, who is the head of the Red Bull Global Influencer Network. And she reached out to me and said that she likes my videos on YouTube. And just like to think that this has given me an opportunity like that is actually ridiculous. And obviously, it's a massive thank you to all of you guys who have helped me to get to this point and to get to these opportunities, because without you, I wouldn't be where I am today. And I know like every YouTuber says that, but it's true. I wouldn't have the opportunities that I have today if you guys didn't support me in continuing what I do with this channel and where I'm going with my life. So I'm just so excited, and we're gonna create the best content there. So what's happening is that I am creating content for the Red Bull social media channel, so check out their international Red Bull channels for that kind of stuff. So that's gonna be pretty cool to have my stuff on Red Bull's channels. So yeah, gonna be creating for their channels, and then also going to be creating for my own channels as well, so Instagram and YouTube. It's gonna be very busy, but also very exciting, and I'm sure the week is gonna go by like that. It is just the week in Santorini, so it's gonna go by very, very quickly, but it's gonna be amazing. I'm so looking forward to it, and this is what I've been working for the past 3 years, to travel the world doing what I love doing, and I don't even have words. I feel like I wanna cry. I'm not gonna cry, but still. Anyway, that is so amazing. And I got a stabilizer, and videos are gonna be banging. Stay tuned for banging videos. For now though, I'm gonna switch to a cinematic sequence of this awesome view in the background that's currently white, but 3, 2, 1. So just to be clear, that was shot without any of the stabilization from the new stabilizer, and I just want to say that you can shoot really steady shots without a stabilizer. Literally everything I've done, I've never had a stabilizer before. So all of the cinematic sequences you see, everything you see has always been handheld. So there definitely is a way of doing it. It does take practice though to have a steady hand. And I use slow motion in conjunction with the warp stabilizer on Premiere Pro. So that is how I get my steady smooth shots. But obviously if I'm going to be running around filming parkour, I'm not going to be steady, so that is the reason why I bought the stabilizer. Anyway, onwards to home and playing around with the stabilizer.
We have made it home with the new Zion crane. I think that's how you say it, Zion. Anyway, we're going to open this now and check it out if I can figure out how to use this thing as well. Okay, we have the box open. So it comes in this really nice hard pelican piece, which is cool. So this is perfect for travel. So not going to get broken anywhere. Open this up. It's got a nice soft padding inside, so that's amazing. And then, okay, we've got the batteries, we've got charger, and then the actual stabilizer. We take this out, looking amazing. So obviously we need to put the batteries in the thing first, so we will start by doing that. We like set this whole thing up in the shop, so hopefully I can remember how to do it, and it won't take too long to set this whole thing up. Screw that in. Okay, so the next step obviously would be to put the camera on here, but I'm filming with the camera right now, so wait, I have another camera. Switch up. 70D is now filming. Anyway, let's get this guy on here. Okay, so we got this pretty much balanced out now. I'm gonna turn this on and hopefully it doesn't just freak out completely. Come on. Oh yeah. Oh, it's so cool. So this is the Zion crane. I'm gonna test it out on some cinematic sequences, maybe get Leo and Slater to run around and see how stable this thing is. Playing around with this thing and I finally figured out how to use it properly and effectively and efficiently, so that is amazing and I'm very happy with it. The quality is amazing, the stabilization is amazing. So later I've decided that I'm probably gonna go to the beach for sunset and take the dogs so that I can test out how well this thing works when I'm running at full speed, because I got to run a bit in the garden but it wasn't really running at full speed, so I think it'll do pretty well, but we'll see later. Hopefully there's a cool sunset as well. Until then, I'm just gonna do some editing. I'm gonna get some food in my stomach and do all the things. What are you saying? So after that very interesting time lapse, we have just been chilling the whole afternoon. We've been playing some Mario Kart and some Super Mario Bros. I have set up the Wii on my TV here. So it's been a bit of a nostalgic afternoon, but it's been very fun. And now we're gonna head to the beach. We might just take Leo because Slade is a bit hectic. And he likes to run away, which we really don't want to deal with right now. It is quite windy at the beach though, so probably not going to do much talking and just test out the cinematics of the stabilizer. Feel so professional just rolling out here with like two cameras, a pelican case, and a cool dog. What are you doing, Leo?
Yeah.
What are you doing? Stop chewing your leash. No, boy. So we have arrived at the beach, but as you can see, it is really windy outside. So I'm just gonna get my shoes off, get the stabilizer all set up, and then we are good to go with all the cinematics. The sun's looking cool. Unfortunately, there's no clouds in the sky, but Table Mountain's always a banger. Leo's always a banger, and we're gonna get some good shots.
these years I've wasted on you. You gave up. I grew.
Are you sure it's not in there?
I hope not.
Okay, so unfortunately we had to cut the trip a bit short. Everything was going super well. The sunset was nice. It was just really windy though, but we were getting the shots and then I cut my foot open on a piece of glass. Like, Leo, like, it's just so annoying. Like, why do people leave glass on the beach? And I've got this massive cut on my foot right before I have to leave for Greece. And I'm just so annoyed. Hopefully it's not too bad. It looks like it stopped bleeding, so that's good. But I just couldn't carry on filming because it really hurts and I can't walk properly. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that very short cinematic sequence. I wish I could have got more, but I'm gonna go home and treat this thing now. Also, we have pizza at home, so that's a plus. But I'm just so annoyed still. Anyway. I hope you had fun at least, Leo. You look like you had fun. Was that fun? Let's hope so. Got my foot all sorted out, so that's good. It's just really annoying. But anyway, got the pizza. We're gonna watch some movies now. And we have decided that tomorrow morning we're gonna go to the beach again and take the dogs for a walk. So I'll throw that cinematic. Why can't I talk? So I'll throw that cinematic sequence into this video as well, just because I feel like today's one wasn't the best as this. So it's all good. Now, and probably turns out that yesterday's cinematic sequence was actually better than the one I took today. It was just really bright and didn't get the best of shots. But anyway, I'm gonna end this video here. It's been quite a long one, but very exciting, and I'm so excited. I'm leaving tomorrow. Oh, it's so good. Anyway, I do hope you guys enjoyed this video. I do have two other separate edits that are coming out soon, but probably only after next week, after I get back from Santorini. But I've got some epic videos lined up and I can't wait to share them with you guys either. So in saying that, I'm gonna end today's video here and I'll see you guys in Santorini. Still blows my mind. Anyway, if you guys like this video, please leave a like. If you're new around here, hit the subscribe button. And in the meantime, stay weird, don't die, and make it happen. I'll see you guys in the next one.